Ah, the twin sons of Tatooine. Aren't they beautiful? Shining bright in their binary star system. Yes. Now, before we burn our eyes out looking at the sun, let's get to work. Hello there, everyone. It's myself again, Jackson Pavan here. Joining you again on another Let's Play for Star Wars Galaxies Legacy. Yes! We're actually continuing on doing this. Maybe one day I will finally be level 90 on Gantt and actually be able to do stuff. But I'm not alone today, even though I'm alone right now where I'm at, standing outside of Watto's junk shop. But with me here I have Noah, also goes by the name of Jet in game for his character. Go ahead and introduce yourself, Noah.
Well, that's me. So not much to introduce.
Yes, not much introduce at all. So we're continuing on Legacy here. Last time we decided to dive deep into the squill, squall, however you say the cave, and potentially came across issues with a Rodian, who I can confirm the Rodian is still off of his meds. That's why we're not inside filming right now, because Watto has his hands full trying to keep the Rodian from destroying stuff, trying to keep pants on the Rodian. It's kind of ridiculous if you ask me. I think it's just like, I don't know, lock him up or something. But we will brave Watto's shop and avoid the Rodian, the crazy, crazy Rodian, to continue on our quest today. So let's just head out. Let's go ahead and head in there. Now, a little disclaimer once again, this is a complete playthrough, and I guess you could say acting through, role play through. I don't know how you'd call it. What would you call it, Noah?
You're just doing legacy, really.
Yes, it's me doing Legacy with very bad voice work as I read the quest chains from Legacy. Oh, let's continue on over here. Check my inventory first before we go. Still looking good. Got enough room. Need to sell some stuff. Alrighty. So once again, as a disclaimer, I do apologize for any potential life-threatening, issues that can pop up from this reading, this Let's Play, or this, anything that can happen. Much including, insanity caused by bad voice acting, bees going into the insane asylum, I don't know what else could go wrong. Spontaneous head explosions is apparently an issue too that I'm told, so we'll see. But let's continue on. Amazing, Outlander! This is quite the achievement, eh? Thanks, Watto. It wasn't easy. Well, it's not over yet. I found the head, but you're not gonna like where it is, I think. What do you mean? I sold it to Jabba the Hutt. Great, so who do I have to talk to? I just told you, Outlander. You must talk to Jabba. That's annoying. It is not good for you, eh? Jabba will not be easy to get to. I didn't think he would be. Just pause here for a moment and ponder on the fact that why did Jabba the Hutt need to buy a random droid head from Watto? Of all people. Well, here's where you can find him. And accepting the quest, tracking the head, level 22. Oh, it's okay, so we're not too far ahead of the quest requirements. This is a pretty straightforward one, which I'm just going to probably, I guess I'll wrap it into a kind of a series of quests, I guess. I believe the track in the head is literally just going to Jabba's palace, right?
Yeah, you don't
Yeah.
really complete tracking the head until you complete Jabba's theme park.
Ah, okay.
Actually, no, yeah, Jabba's theme park. If you've done Mort's quest, on the other hand, and you did it neutral, you don't need to do Jabba's theme park.
Yeah, but Jabba's theme park gives you so much XP.
True, but it's annoying.
I enjoyed Jabba's theme park. I thought it was fun at some points. I
I enjoy
mean,
the Rebel and Imperial theme park, but Jabba's is.
yeah.
Ugh.
Well, I think part of the problem, I guess, could probably come from the fact that you did it back on live, right? Yeah, and everyone has to do it because you can't do Legacy without it. It's a big chunk of it. Alright, so let's go and grab a ticket here. Now what we're going to do is we're going to travel to a place called Wayfar. Which, no, it's actually already in Wayfar, so just head over there. Grab a ticket. And let's hope we don't miss the shuttle. I guess missing the shuttle's not that bad, but it would be horrible if we were back on the old timing system.
Which, Five minutes.
Yeah, for anyone who doesn't know, back in the day, back when Galaxies got its own like full quest line and you had to go places to grind stuff, the wait time for the shuttle was 5 minutes. Every shuttle. Doesn't matter where. Can you just imagine like sitting around for 5 minutes listening to me talk, trying to kill time? Ah, there he is. That'd be horrible.
True.
Alrighty. So, you have a mouse droid.
I do.
We're close to Jabba's palace, way in the distance, and we're in the fair city of Wayfar, a place that I'm actually going to do a video on in the future. Although you were saying there was some like weird ritual thing you came across?
Yeah, it's actually right over here.
Where?
I don't like it. I don't like it.
Huh. Nope, I'm getting out of here. Let's go.
I'm shutting up the mouse droid now.
Let's go ahead and head over to Jabba's. Now, his whole quest line is pretty straightforward, though. You go to one place, you shoot stuff. You go to other place, you shoot stuff. You gather up food for him because he's...
fat.
That's... yeah, I was going to use that word, but then I decided that might not be too nice. But you know, yeah, that's right. Fat. He's a slug. Ugly. Eats a lot. I will say, though, I do like his location, though.
Mm-hmm.
It's such a cool little area. And it's a pain.
From doing the Jabba theme park, when we get to the proper level, we can actually do Boba Fett's quest line.
That's right. DC 15, or, well, I've got to run it twice, so for the DC 15A and the DC 15S.
Mm-hmm.
Alrighty, so we come up here, you run to the door. I don't remember, do I have to talk to this guy first or no?
Nah, you just reload.
That's right.
Collection!
Ooh. The Lance of the Runaway. Alright, run up here. Oh. Okay.
You can't get past there.
You run up here and talk to this guy. Rilo Bodruk. Let's see, how do I do this? A sleazy kind of voice? I mean, all these guys are going to sound similar because they're all sleazy.
He's a Rodian. Of course he's going to be sleazy.
Yeah. You look like you might have some fight in ya. Want to work for Jabba? Not really, no? Or let's hear about the job first instead. How about that? Smart! You want to know what you're up against before you tackle it. I like that. Okay, here's the deal. You ever hear of the Alcahara Bandits? No, who are they? Well, a long time ago, there was this bandit named Alcahara. Allied himself with the Sand People and took out the police garrison. Problem is, he immediately turned on the Sand People that helped him and slaughtered them all. Lovely. Sounds like a nice guy. Yeah, he's one of those reasons that there's still a feud between Sand People and normal folks. Anyway, Alcahara died, and recently a group of people who were ousted from their homes by Sand People got together and reformed themselves into a group called the Alcahara's Bandits. Which would be fine if they'd just stick to fighting the Sand People. I take it that they're more trouble than that. Way more trouble. They have to keep supplied, so they hit some of the outlying farms and merchants and such. Trouble is those people who pay Jabba for protection. Jabba in his infinite capacity for selflessness, selfless behavior, is now actually going to honor those contracts. You're going to go make sure the Akaharians stop attacking the merchants by killing them. You got it. Now, get out there and make us proud. Don't come back until you killed at least 10 of them. Sweet. Still pretty decent XP for this quest. What level is it, though?
2018.
Alrighty. What I'll probably do is I might make the entire theme park just one quest line. So, this here is the start of Jabba's theme park. That's pretty straightforward. You hop out here, and somehow, these, bandits built a base over here, right under Jabba's nose.
Without getting destroyed.
Yeah, about to say.
Should be an easy wipe, though, the level 15.
Oh, yeah. Murder them all. Good work! Jabba wants you to take care of some Valerian soldiers who are skulking around the palace. Oh, lovely. So yes, after you kill 10 of them, you run over here and kill more people.
Woo. They say goodbye to you too.
Did they say no, they didn't say goodbye to me.
I had two of them say goodbye as we left.
Weird. Yeah, the only thing I got is why you little. Seriously, this guy must pay a ton for his property right there.
That's the property of, used to stay at Jabba's palace all day.
Mm-hmm. No, just the protection money alone.
It's obviously not very well protected. Valoran, you can build a base right out here, too.
Yeah! I mean, these... You know what? I blame it on a Clone Wars bunker or something. I mean... There has to be some reason why they can just build stuff out this out in the middle of nowhere. Some of Valerian's people are buying up gambling debts. Take the vouchers from them so we can cash them in ourselves.
That's a little illegal.
You expect this place controlled by the Hutts. So yeah, you just come inside and you murder their bookkeepers. God, aren't we like just the most badass clones ever? Taking on the most dangerous foes. The bookkeeper. Then again, though, to be fair, the Clone Wars probably would have been over quicker, say, had we, just killed the intergalactic banking clan and taken all the money. Alright, one moment here. I need to adjust volume a little bit. There we go. Sound effects are a little too loud. I mean, that was one thing that was interesting about the Clone Wars. So the Intergalactic Banking Clan, in lore, was giving out loans to both the, oh, get to return to him now. They were giving out loans both to the Grand Army of the Republic and the Confederacy, and also took part of the CIS, and had major members a part of it. Now, I know they're, like, the biggest clan out there, but wouldn't it make sense to, like, seize those assets and, you know, just take them for yourself? As a Republic? Or is that just too nice?
I guess it would make sense, but that would be way too evil of the Republic?
I guess it would be evil for the Republic, because they give out loans and stuff to everyone. And technically, the Banking Clan is neutral. So, they're neutral, air quotation marks here.
Like us in World War One.
Yeah.
Until they sank Lusitania. And then we were done.
Alright, let's get back to this guy. Excellent! We'll start collecting on these immediately. Now, if you're still hungry for some work, I suggest you talk to my friend, Re-Yees. He'll have something for you to do. Alright, and collect that. Oh. I forgot to take my daily pill of XP boost. Alright, there's Re-Yees. I'm not even going to try to voice this guy, because I know they speak in, like, tongues or something. Oh, like they have, like, a type of voice or something like that. Really weird. I guess I could do... Relo says that you're alright. Some things have gone missing, and I'd like you to go retrieve them. What has gone missing? An item we acquired recently. A famed musician was touring Tatooine a few weeks ago, and we stole his gem-encrusted bell. The one they used to signal the end of the concert. The Sand Splitters walked out of here with it and are looking for a buyer. Get it back from them. Someone stole from Jabba? Yeah, we caught one of them as they were escaping. The Sonic had a nice little snack that day. But the rest of them got away. Word is that one of the knaves must be carrying it around. So I should just find that Sand Splitter knave. That's what I was thinking. Though, we don't know who has it, so you may have to go through a few of them to get to the guy. See if you can find the bell, and when you do, I'll have something else for you to do. Anything else? Nope, that's all. Get the gem-encrusted bell and we'll give you a call. Cool. Now we get a ring out of this. So, Jabba the Hutt steals a bell.
Yep.
Okay. Jabba the Hutt steals a bell from a famous musician that's used to end a concert. And then a whole bunch of people steal from Jabba.
Can't they just all get along?
No? God, what do you think this is? A republic?
No.
I will say this much, though. It does take a lot of, you know, it does take a lot of kahunas to steal from Jabba the Hutt. I mean, the guy has a pet sand creature that he feeds people to.
Sarlacc and a Rancor.
And I wouldn't be surprised if he had more stuff.
That poor little thug, what's he doing out here?
I don't know, I think he's sniffing this pink stuff here.
Don't smell that, Ganch.
Ah, no clue what it is. Alright. So anyway, it should be pretty straightforward. We go in here and kill people till we find the bell?
Yep.
Is it at the bottom of the cave? I don't remember. Whatever.
Die. Kill it till you find it.
Oh! Jabba's missing a ledger containing valuable information. It was stolen by the sand splitters, and he demands a return. Find the thug that has it. It shouldn't take long. Okay.
So this is actually on the ground somewhere.
Yeah.
Here. Sort of small, too.
I think I remember where this one is. I'm gonna rush up to where you are. I believe the ledger... should be over here. Yeah. There we go.
Helps if you have all item names turned on.
It does. Alrighty. So just kill more of them.
Yep.
Jabba had a prototype warhead in the garage. It's missing. Those sand splitters once again. I had no idea they stole so much when they left. But they've just now gotten Jabba's attention. He wants them ended for once and for all. Ooh.
Why does Jabba have a warhead?
Why doesn't Jabba have a warhead? That's the question.
It's terrifying, actually.
It explains why that Valerian base was allowed to be built there, though. I mean, had he had his warhead, he could have blown him up.
So close to his own base of operations.
Eh, it's not that bad. I mean, look at the size of his palace. It could take a few hits. Alright, and with that, we murderize all of them, come up to the warhead, touch it.
Don't touch the warhead.
Deactivate it? Run. Run! You know what would be amazing? If the devs could come back to this game, if devs, if you're listening to this, because I know a few of you have watched me in the past, after we get a whole bunch of other stuff done, okay? After certain issues are fixed, more balancing is done. Commandos, or not commandos, officers can use carbines. You guys add in my LAAT maybe one day. Wink, wink.
No.
But I need the LAAT. Preferably with fire protection damage for Mustafar, because that never made sense to me at all. But you know what would be great is if they went back and not remake Legacy, but...
update it.
Yeah, update it, remaster it. I mean, there are effects you can use in here. Like, for example, with Storyteller, you can get explosion effects and stuff like that. So an updated version for this here, you know, maybe have, like, set up triggers or something like that, because the game does have, certain triggers that will happen when you enter in places or go in areas. Set up triggers while you're running out of the cave and have it where the cave's blowing up around you. Granted, obviously, if you don't get out in time, you don't die, because they're just, you know, for effect, but it'd be a cool effect. And yes, while that would take a long, you know, that would take time to do, it's part of the reason why I say, don't do it until, get everything done. Anyway, so we're gonna go ahead and head back here now, back to Re-Yeets. So tiny.
But don't shoot at me.
I think they're shooting at me, not you. No. Oh. Nope, they're shooting at you too.
Shooting at me too.
And then they blow up your bark and you can't fix it.
I'll kill myself.
Nah. You know what? Alhai's bark, when we first started playing, got blown up like in the first day or so.
100k Regal Restoration Kit.
Oh no, we went out. I went into space and helped to grind that out. Just to fix it. Nice! Level up! Alright, let's talk to this guy. You did it! Excellent! The bell, the book, and they, well, I feel like I should say candle, but I'm not sure why. Anyway, you did good work. I'm not sure, maybe that would be a good name for this warhead, the candle. Anyway, you did good work. Ephant Mon wants to speak to you about these syntax pirates here. Take your reward and go upstairs to see him. Now, I think if you talk to Bruce here, what questline does Bruce do? Oh. You also complete that. Stolen ring. Am I wearing anything? Nope, not yet. Stolen ring gives you 4 constitution. Woo! There's Bruce over here, who I think is kind of a part of it. I don't know. We'll hit Bruce on the way out, just for completion reasons. Alright, so are you ready for this? At all? Where are you? Did I lose you? We might have lost Jet here.
I'm sorry, it appears I lost sound for a second.
Oh, there you are. I was about to say, are you ready for this?
Not emotionally.
Alrighty. So we come up to this guy. Ephant Mon. Oh, I'm wondering if I should do the voice as a Jamaican or not. I heard you have no trouble taking care of the sand splitters for Reese. Yeah, that's about right. Just mentioning it all, have you ever heard of the syntax? They're a bad lot worse than the Huts. And I say that with all due respect. They're slave traders, and slave trading's been outlawed on Tatooine. You got it? Is there some history with Jabba and slave trading? Jabba's a little more clever than most people realize, which is one of the reasons why he stayed in business for so long. Not long ago, Jabba ran the slave trade on Tatooine, before it was outlawed. Right, he cut a deal with another Hut, Gurdula. Gurdula got all slave trading, Jabba got all the other illegal activities. And? Jabba knew the outlaw of slave trading was coming. Shortly thereafter, Gurdula was arrested and disappeared. Jabba has been running things ever since. Interesting story. Not really. But now you know it anyway. You want some work or not? Yeah, sure, whatever you got. Syntax causing trouble. Bringing heat to the planet, and Jabba doesn't like it. Start thinning the Syntax herd, will you? Alright, cool. Where are these guys at? Alright.
Oh yeah, middle of nowhere.
Lovely. Oh, I know where this place is. I went there about a week ago. For a completely unrelated reason, too.
Why?
Roleplay.
What were you doing in the middle of Tatooine?
Ran, being an NPC.
For who?
For a guild member, Xanus. Dealt with his character, bringing him back into the game.
What was not invited?
It was like a single person hunt. Technically dealt with him, technically dealt with him getting blown up and ending up in an old hermit's house. So, not exactly fun.
The old hermit, or
the old? Oh, okay. So, the story behind it though is it wasn't on Tatooine, because the old hermit's dead.
He's not dead. He's a force ghost.
Dead. There we go. Good old tie. Sweet matching ties.
Dry Gulch does not have a shuttle port.
Alrighty then. Well, we're gonna go back to Mos Espa, Starport West. Oh yeah, so I picked a random sand planet for a roleplay. Used Tatooine as that planet, and I picked a random bunker, which turned out to be this bunker.
People farming the slum thieves here.
Yeah. Keep up the good work, guys. At least I got someone who's over there inviting people to it. That's one problem with it is, you know, if you do that and you don't invite people to it, I mean, if you do it, it's okay. But if you don't invite people to it, you're just kind of a jerk.
They're inviting because that's a legacy area.
Yeah, they're inviting because it's a legacy. That's the other thing, too, is if you do stuff like that where you are picking up a spawn point and that's needed for a legacy quest and people can't continue on, that will get you booted off. I think like the first offense is just a kick out of the game, and then you get like a 24-hour ban if you continue on to do it without running a invite macro. Invite macro is so easy to do, so. So how are you doing back there in your slow arc speeder?
They move the same speed.
And why am I ahead then?
Because you started out ahead. I think it's the skiff, the command bark, the bark, and the ATRT all move the same speed, I think.
Yeah. You know what I was actually thinking of getting though? I was thinking of either grinding up another 4 million and getting a second ATRT for my alt. Or a Basculus War Droid. Or both.
Well, Basculus War Droid has lava protection from Mustafar.
It does. That's part of the reason why I'd want it. But I just like the ATRT. Walker design in general. Alrighty. After short travel here, after going back to Espa, you come to this bunker. Yeah. Watch the trap. Does nothing. Good job for your security guys. And just come in here and tenderize them all.
That's a weird way to word it. We don't get any XP for killing these nerds.
Nah. I think there might have been a quest actually in this bunker before, but I could be wrong.
You're doing the entirety of Legacy, aren't you?
Yep. Which I highly recommend if you want this character to do stuff to not follow me with it. Because it'll take forever.
Eh, I have nothing else better to do.
Wait a second. This man's dead. And I didn't kill him.
Who didn't kill him? 90 running around in here.
Wait, what? Where? Oh, great.
Not sure what he's doing. Probably worked out his theme park.
Probably. But yeah, I'm doing the full legacy. I actually probably already have the option to bypass
you can't get a point that yet. Not till 30.
Yeah, not till 30, but I'm gonna do all of Naboo. So.
Yeah.
What I'll probably do is I'll try to blitz through it as quick as I can, though. Just because it'll be easy for one, and I feel like I have to do it. Alrighty. You showed a lot of spirit out there. Now it's time to move on to the heavy lifting. Find the Syntax Slave Masters. Plenty of them around. I want 5 of them destroyed, understand? Okay.
We're both snared.
Well, I guess technically, shouldn't I be speaking in like a Mori voice or something like that? Or like not Australian, but, God, my mind is going blank on the country I'm thinking about. New Zealand voice.
I mean, not sure why you would.
Well, for clones.
Oh, yeah, true. There's no more slave masters in there.
One by a deer. I think it's 2 more, actually. No, look out, over there. Yeah, 1 XP. I feel like I'm achieving something every time it pops up there. On the bright side, I should get a level up, so. I actually don't remember how I got ahead so far. I think it's because, we might have started this series. Oh, hold on. Syntax guards carrying key chips they use to access the databanks. Collect the key chips until you have enough to break into their databanks. Should be take about 9 of them. That's a very oddly specific number. You know a lot about their systems there, Ephant Mon.
Well, the reason you're so far ahead is HP is doubled here.
That's true, but I believe... Legends. That's true, it is double on Legends as it is, but at the same time, though, I think when I first started the series, for like 2 days, it was like 4 times XP or something, so... That does make life a little bit easier.
Legacy that naturally pushes you ahead of itself, just because the XP being doubled, plus you use your XP buff, and you have the chip.
Mm-hmm. Hey, as long as this keeps on giving me XP and doesn't require me to, skip ahead, that's fine. Three more. Wait, I have an idea.
What's that?
Alright, let him follow me. Let's see how well this works. There we go. You surpassed my expectations! Now you need to use those key chips. Find the central computer in the Syntax hideout and wipe all their information. That ought to slow them down.
Actually, you're right here.
Barely?
No, it's not. I lied. It's not interesting me.
Yeah, I think it's for something different. Where is it? think it's up this way in that back room. Kind of interesting, though, that they claim slavery is illegal on Tatooine, though. So, those dancers Jabba have, they're just there for fun, right? No, well, it's not in this room. Not interest me. Did your sound cut out again?
No, I'm just looking for the terminal.
Ah. You know what's really bad about this, though? I keep on wanting to hit force run and realize I don't have it.
I think commandos do get a speed boost, though. Costs kill points.
Yeah, but we don't get it till like... Oh, here we go. Syntax database. Found it. So it's down in this room here. I'm gonna click on this.
I brought friends.
You do good work, I'll say that. Bring it home. Head back to the place and or palace and let me know... Let me give you a little something for your time. Maybe even introduce you around. Sweet.
I don't want to be introduced around.
Oh, come on, he's gonna show you some of the cool places to go. I mean, with a guy named Ephant Mon, I mean, what could be the worst that could happen?
Unspeakable things.
I would just expect to come out with a large case of the munchies. We should be able to call our stuff here close by.
Not too close. You gotta speed her out. Back to way far.
Correctly, I do believe we go into the Jabba food quest next.
I think it's the last quest before you can go to Jabba. Yep.
Yeah, there's so many of them.
There's two more quest lines after this one. I lied.
There's quite a few other NPCs in there too that I don't touch in part of the main quest lines.
Yeah, but I don't think anyone really ever touches them.
Yeah, I don't remember ever doing them in live either. I will do them for the sake of this Let's Play, but...
Only extra I did in Jabba's Palace is Boba Fett's questline.
Oh, yes.
That's just because I want a DC-15.
You go for the carbine or the rifle?
Rifle.
I have to run that quest line twice, so. Alrighty.
Then I'll just break it down into a schematic and have it recrafted. Alright, for a pretty penny, too.
Well, the price form is pretty. I mean, the DC-15 recrafted's going for about 15 billion right now on the market.
You're looking at the Mastercraft schematic,
No, not the Mastercraft, the standard one. What's bad though is some people are posting up not the they're not looking at what they are. So some people are like looting it up and posting the standard one for 15 million next to the recrafted ones. So the prices are kind of insane right now. Anyway, so we're back at Ephant Mon, or however you say his name. It's done. I had a feeling about you. These old bones never lie. Oh, wait, he's old? Oh. These old bones never lie. No, I'm not going to do that. I promised you a reward, and now here it is. Enjoy it. If you've got some time, you might go see Porculus in the kitchen. I hear he's been having a hard time, and if you could use a good meal, there's no place better on Tatooine to get one. I don't know if I trust that. Also, level up. Alright, so we gotta look for Porculus. And dead end. Okay, Porculus, where are you? Are you this way? That's also a dead end. I think Porculus is this way. Now, what I want to know... Nope, not that way. Ah, here we go. Porculus. Or Porcellius, but me, he will always be Pork. Alrighty. Can I make this guy Italian? Say, you look a handy! I have to get in trouble for that. Say, you look handy. I could use someone to scrounge together some ingredients for me. Can you help me out? Oh. Whoops. Slight technical difficulties here. So, what happened?
I don't know, actually. I think my TeamSpeak crashed.
Nice. Well, then you completely missed me talking Italian.
Good.
I could use some, wait, I already read that. Can you help me out? I don't cook. Oh, that just well, just as well. You probably couldn't have handled it anyway. What? No, that's a lie.
Yeah, see, I don't want to do this quest option there.
Lovely. Isn't that the stop conversation option, too? What exactly are you cooking? Oh, this is going to be great. I've been Jabba's slave, chef for a long time. I'm going to make him the best meal he's ever had, and then when he's satisfied and in a good mood, I'm going to ask him to release me. You'll have to say yes. So, what are you cooking? A 5-course meal. Stuffed dune lizard gizzards appetizers. Beetle broth. Squill liver salad. Dragonette snakes. And Zuka fruit pastries for dessert. We'll also probably need some wine. Alright, where should I start? Fantastic! If you're going to start by bringing me gizzards... Gizzards from lizards. Dune lizards, to be exact. Dune lizard gizzards. Hey, that's fun to say. Okay. Start with that.
Not.
And I'll let you know what else we need after that. So. Are those sweet rolls?
Just let me in, Jabba. Jabba, just let me in. Please, let me in here.
It'd be great if Max. It'd be great if you did this so many times they would like call the guards on you or something.
Revamp legacy quest.
Yep. Revamp legacy quest. Try to see Jabba too early, you get the guards called on you, or you get dropped into the Rancor pit. Both would be awesome.
CL90 Gold Elite Rancor.
And that's how you make people rage quit. This quest is pretty straightforward from what I remember. We gotta kill Dune Lizards for their gizzards.
And
right over here.
He gives you more things to go kill, more things to go kill.
13 Dune Lizard gizzards.
Best thing for you to do is just to spam your AoE abilities.
Yeah.
I don't have mine yet. Oh, I hate these things. They poison your action.
That's right, they do. The best thing to do is take them on one at a time.
Nah, that keeps us alive.
That's right, you're running the medic class, right?
Mm-hmm. Actually, I can't keep you alive, but I don't have action to keep you alive.
Dragging too many of them. Stop!
Ask for this.
Alright, run in circles, run in circles. We got this, we got this.
Just throw a grenade. There. They're dead.
Now, time for the soup. Jabba likes good beetle broth. He calls it stew, but it's actually broth. We need beetle carcasses. For flavor, I'd say about 15 rock or cave beetles, either one. Mmm, this sounds delicious. So...
turn off your chronicle loot.
I think mine is off? I don't remember. What's
mine's off.
Yeah.
/ chronicles.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I'm about to dump my inventory soon.
I'm gonna start keeping parts and start selling those. Stacks of 1,000 gets you 4 million.
Which parts?
Parts in general. Mm. Junk. I think in top left says parts is useful for a 35.
That's true. I'm just kind of lazy and I just end up kind of trading it away. It's like the worst thing you could do too, but whatever. Generally, whenever I want to make money for 35s or something like that, I go and hunt Night Sisters.
More grenades. That's also useful. Pull back top four of that gets about 5 million. I think 23 plus.
Are you sure it's / Chronicle?
Chronicles.
Okay. There we go. Loot disabled. I know back on live there used to be a button you could toggle for it, so that's how I used to do it.
There isn't any options, I don't know where it is. Cluster bombs in these.
And boom. Jabba's picky about his salads. He will eat squill liver salad, though. So I need you to bring me mountain squill livers. Not desert squills. Too rubbery. Mountain squills only.
Wow. This poor artisan is out here. I think we can get off.
Oh.
Valoran, what are you doing here?
I'm just keep walking.
But I did not know until the what is it? the containment center. No, not containment center. The, well, the Dethomirian place. Zombies.
Yeah.
That quest line. Did not know that Valoran was not a human until I did that quest line.
Oh, yeah. Valoran's like some elephant monster thing. Who's apparently a lady.
Makes me wonder. I wonder if Ephant Mon and Valoran have something together.
I think he would be killed.
Probably. They don't know about it.
Weird little village out in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah. Probably Future City or something. Or one guy's storage houses. Yeah, one guy's storage houses.
Squill is also poison your action, I think.
Yep.
Yeah, I think, I don't know if pets can actually learn that ability. It'd be really nice if they could.
So I'm gonna get up to 20 points on my commando track and then run into like a big group of them and blow them up.
Like one in the middle over there?
Yeah. That's the plan. These guys should be enough to get me up there, so.
That stormtrooper do that.
Yeah, there's no other stormtroopers on here, just that random do-bag.
Yeah.
There we go, hang on. Got a big group of them. Oh, there we go. Right in the center. Need more kills. Oh. There we go. Do it. Do it. Ba-boom.
You seem rather excited about that.
I am. Well, that was anticlimactic.
Anticlimactic, yeah.
Hold on. Try it again. Pull these guys right here. There we go. Dragonette flank steaks are the main course. Their meat is so succulent. Yes, flanks. Dragonette flanks. 16 of them, if you don't mind. Now, is this meal only for Jabba, or is it for,
I think
everyone?
It's only for Jabba.
Okay. Now, the better question, though, and so he's gonna feed him this five-course meal. Let's just take apart his plan here. He's gonna feed him this five-course meal. He's going to... Then, after he's happy and he's full... And, you know, probably getting tired, he's going to turn around and try to ask for his freedom. Can you see what might go wrong with this situation here?
Rancor pit.
That or Jabba's going to laugh at him and keep him on his chef because, oh, you made such a good meal.
Being spit at.
Yeah, these guys are nasty.
I really hate you on this quest line. Everything you kill poisons your actions except for the beetles.
Yeah.
My heal. Tiny as it is.
Oh.
The scout troopers are not enjoying them either. Oh, that, well. Okay. That scout trooper got destroyed.
Rest his soul.
He's a veteran, too. Wow.
It's like, I survived the Clone Wars. I survived Mandalorian Civil War. I've been attacked by rebels. What's the worst that could happen with a bunch of desert dragonettes? And with this last one, 16. For dessert, Zuka fruit pastries. No common Zuka meat. Get a wild boar. I'd say you could go buy some, but Jabba won't eat something we paid for. Kill them yourself.
Does he have to know we paid for it, though?
No, he doesn't have to know, but this guy's trying to get his freedom. Oh.
Jabba's picky. Come on, spot him. There we go. I should probably start despawning my ATRT as we go along.
I just do it because I know NPCs will shoot at it, and it'll be annoying as fuck. Oh, sorry. It'd be annoying to deal with. It won't be that bad for you. It's just like 15k repair cost.
Yeah, if you lose the, if you blow up the bark, though, god, that's so expensive to repair.
100k for visual restoration for that thing. Maybe
yeah. It's not, okay.
These are... Oh, these, I thought these were random. You don't get it every time. Apparently you do.
Yep.
Okay.
No, they're random. Oh, hang on. Let's just kill... Oh, there we go. The last thing we need is wine. The best wine comes from, well, it doesn't matter. Jabba won't drink the best wine. He has a taste for this Corellian Relot. Get it from the Valerian thugs. That sounds like he's, you know. Did we help the troopers?
No, they're fine.
Okay.
They'll survive.
Survival of the fittest here. Weed out the weak by fighting him on Tatooine. Anyway. So.
Wine killing will be Valoran for wine.
Yes.
Oh god.
Hopefully Valoran has good wine.
Tantive 4 shuttle. Not shuttle. Speeder thing over there.
Party buses!
No, we don't talk about those.
You know, I'd really wish they'd add in, though.
What's that?
I mean, I would go Rebel just for this vehicle, but back on, like, what, the last Empire Day, or one of the later Empire Days, they added in a AT-ST and AT-XT as a vehicle.
Mm-hmm.
I think it was 2010, so it wasn't the last Empire Day, but it was like the one right before it.
I should really just add TCG back, like the entire game. Just add TCG.
Yeah. It takes a lot of work, though.
Yeah, but it was actually pretty fun.
It was. The way I would handle it, though, is I would have it where possibly like rare packs could drop, or rare cards could drop from NPCs, maybe, in game.
Kind of like EverQuested?
Yeah. And then you could buy different packs, you know, for credits. I mean, like him or hate him, you know, credit sync's kind of important to the economy for any game, you know. If you don't have a credit sync, people just get credits and then stop playing. And they used to have an amazing credit sink in here that I know that anyone who hears this will hate me for saying it, but the decay system, had it been tweaked, could have been a perfect system for a... There's a random Inquisitor over there in the desert, alone.
Is it you, Jackson?
No. Cool. But no, the decay system's the perfect system for it if you tweaked it right. But of course, you know,
yeah,
whenever you bring...
See it.
Whenever you bring decay up to anyone, though, it's an immediate no, because no one likes the idea of having to repair their items or armor.
Yeah, but once you buy something from a weaponsmith or an armorsmith, you never talk to them again, unless you're buying more weapon or armor.
See, that's the problem. The way I would handle it, and this is what I brought up before, but every time, you know, I bring up an option of, every time I bring up the option of... Grim Trifle? Maybe it's not auto-loot on. Every time I bring up the option for... Or, well, I've only brought it up once, so... And it's not like I'm pushing this all the time, but... Anytime the option's been brought up, you know, to other people, though, outside of the Senate, it's always been, you know, an instant, no, we don't want, you know, we don't want our stuff to decay. But the way I see it, though, is if I were to design the system, I would make it easy. Okay, back on emulator, whenever your stuff decayed, it was actually easier to rebuy your weapon than it was to, repair it. Okay, but with with NGE, that's not really possible, because, you know, when you pay... $10 million for a Mastercrafted or DC-15, you're not going to want to pay that $10 million again. The way I would handle it, though, is I would have it degrade in levels, personally. Like, I'd have it start off at a base level where it's at in-game. If you use a weapon for a long period of time and you don't take care of it, it will degrade down to something that's still useful, but, you know, not getting the maximum out of it. But then I'd also have a third level of like a cleaned or maintained weapon state, where essentially you in my idea, which would probably be a pain to code, but in my idea, what you would do is when you have decay on, instead of having a weaponsmith fix it and have the chance of the weapon being completely broken, if you try to use a weapon repair kit yourself, have the weaponsmiths make a repair kit that not only completely fixes the weapon, but also gives you a slight bonus to that weapon for a short amount of time. So maybe, you know, if you clean your weapon, you know, once a week, or you know, if you clean a weapon once a week, you'll get like a 5-day bonus or something like that, where you're actually putting out more damage because your weapon is clean and maintained. That makes sense. But the way I'd make it, though, is I'd let those kits be used by anyone, so you don't have to go to someone to buy it. But I would let, you know, it would be made by, obviously, by the weaponsmith. I don't know. What do you think of that idea?
I could see it. Mm. Yeah. Not my personal want.
How would you handle it? Because people were always talking about needing a credit sink or something along those lines. And I think... For myself, I'd see that being one of the better ways to do it.
Hey, level 24. I don't actually know the way I would do it.
Alright, so here, we're back with this guy here. Ah, yes, these ingredients will do perfectly. Oh, I can't thank you enough. Jabba will have to let me go after this meal. This is going to be the best meal I've ever cooked. Can you think of anything for me to do now? Yes, you should head down to the garage and see, Barada. I brought him some snacks a little while ago, and he was complaining about something needing help with something. Cool. Oh. And I should complete this quest here.
Oh god, where's this quest taking me?
Some place you don't want to know about. Because I really don't know where.
You'll see.
Okay. Oh look, it's our little friend, the Rancor.
Pet him.
Oh no. Okay, there we go. It appeared that I got stuck on the door there for a second. Surely would have been my doom. Ah, here we go. My goodness, he's ugly. Well, what I'm going to do now, have you already grabbed the quest from him?
Yes.
Alright, well, I'm actually going to go ahead and break this off here real quick and take a quick break before we continue on.
So if you guys are watching on the series right now, this once again was a let's play of the Jabba's Palace. I guess you could say this is what? Jabba's Palace Part 1?
Yeah, about halfway through. Over half.
Yeah, about halfway through. So we'll finish the next part here in just a moment. But for anyone who's watching this in here, or anyone who's a subscriber, a current subscriber, I want to thank you for watching. Make sure you catch the next episode, which should probably be up, actually probably around the same time, but we're going to split these here. But I want to thank you for watching, and you all have a good day.